I think I keep chopping the top of my head off with this thing. I'll get used to it. Anyway, so I've been having conversations with people about my vlog and how to make it more interesting and get more subscribers, because I need subscribers. I have two. Thank you, two people. That's very nice. But I would like more. In my first vlog, hello cat. In my first vlog, I said that this video would be a sort of diary about getting into acting and singing and all that, but obviously that's a really slow process and I don't want to have loads of videos where I'm just sitting there going, oh, nothing happened today, life's really boring, I'll just be a bit of a weirdo now. So I've come up with some things that I can do that hopefully will make it more interesting for you. The first thing that I'm going to start adding into my weekly, daily, whatever these turn out to be, vlogs is sort of reviews and recommendations. I'm going to do a top five. Films, television programmes, books, bands, all that sort of thing. And I'll put links for all the things I review in the, so that you can check them out yourself and, you know, discover some new things, maybe, hopefully. Okay, so I'm going to tell you about my favourite music. I'm going to tell you my top five, in no particular order, favourite bands and singers. So, first of all, there's this guy.
Bless you, all of you pretty girls, village and city girls by the quayside. Bless you, all of you pretty girls, watching and waiting by the sea. Bless you, all of you pretty girls, quiet and witty girls by the quayside. Bless you, all of you pretty girls, watching and waiting there for me.
His name's Jim Murray. He is a folk singer. He does really funky things with his music. He takes really traditional words and tunes and makes them really modern. He uses electric instruments, which obviously when the songs were originally written didn't exist. I don't even know how to describe his music. He would probably call it prog folk, but I'm not entirely sure what that means, except prog is short for progressive. Anyway, I'm not much of a music buff, I just enjoy it. So yeah, check him out. He does some incredible things. He's a very recent discovery of mine and I just love him. So, my next recommendation is another folk singer. Don't panic, they're not all folk. I am just a little bit obsessed. And this is him.
Out of the moonlight, the month of May, the ship would take her last breath, her full mast. It was draping like a mummy, she was dressed. Lonely heart, setting free, was all her cares. They went sailing out to sea.
His name is Seth Lakeman. He's kind of like Jim Murray in as much as he's bridging the gap between folk music and pop music. He's making it really mainstream, he's bringing it to a younger, more mainstream audience. He is the best live show that I've been to. There's a list of gigs on his website which is linked in the whatever that is. So if you're interested, check him out, see if he's playing near you, and go along. I couldn't recommend it more. It's foot stomping, fiddle, crazy, sweaty. It's like a folk mosh pit, and it's awesome. Yeah, so that's him. My third recommendation is not folk. Woo! This is a band called the Bluetones.
Look, look what I've done, look what I do. I'm starting to pull myself through. Hell could feasibly freeze, but in your eyes I'll always be the fountainhead, the boy whose thoughts keep running away. And you know I am right.
So this band have been around for a long time. I've been a fan of theirs pretty much since they started out, which was in 1990 something. I was about 10 anyway when I started listening to them. What I really like about them is their use of lyrics, and I guess this links to my love of folk music. Like, to me, a song, the most important part of a song is its lyrics. If the lyrics don't make sense or are just a bit weak, to me it doesn't matter how good the tune is. If the lyrics are rubbish, then this band, literally when I started listening to them, I had to have a dictionary next to me to look up some of the words that they used. I thought they were just making up words at the beginning to sort of make it scan, and they didn't. All of their words made sense, and my vocabulary was widened by this band. So thank you to the Bluetones for making me a better English speaker. So this band are called My Life Story. There is hundreds of people in this band, and they sound like this.
She prefers the night to die.
Same sort of time as the Bluetones. Very dramatic, they're very showy, massive strings, orchestras. I suppose they sort of mix classical music with pop music, and it's just a really good little marriage of styles. Again, their lyrics are incredible. It's like poetry. And what I like about them is Jake Shillingford, the lead singer, I don't think could be considered the best singer by a long stretch. But it doesn't matter, because of the way he puts himself forward and the way he performs, just, it's a bit mind-blowing. That's a really good show to watch as well. They don't gig that often together. Jake Shillingford does a lot of solo things. I'll put a link for his stuff in the What's It as well. Yeah, they're just really fun. They don't take themselves too seriously. They're very dramatic and emotional. And their songs just play out like novels. And get completely immersed in them, and they're just amazing. Okay, so my final singer today is this guy. IAMX. I'm not entirely sure where he gets that from. He He used to be in the Sneaker Pimps. I don't know if any of you remember the Sneaker Pimps. They did songs like this one.
Take me down, six underground, the ground beneath your feet.
He's another showy performer. I obviously, you can tell I'm into theatre when you see the people that I like watching and listening to. He's very electro, he uses a lot of keyboards and electronic instruments, electric guitars, electric drums, synths. I don't really know what to say about him. He's just very showy, puts a, very poetic. Not the sort of music, I actually dismissed him the first time I heard him because I was like, this is not my thing. Like, it was a bit weird and I thought it was a bit, I don't know, he wears makeup and stuff and I was a bit like, oh, weird. And then weird like jaunty hats and glitter and it's just weird. He's just weird, but he's another good live show. So if there are gigs near you, check them out and go, because he's epic, basically. You might have noticed that the five that I've chosen are all men. That's not really a coincidence. I tend to think that men are better singers than women. I do like female singers. I listen to Katie Tunstall. There's a band called Robots in Disguise who are wicked. Kate Nash, Lily Allen, Ellie Goulding, love Ellie Goulding, Marina and the Diamonds, love them. But I don't know, I think I've always preferred male singers. In the same way that I prefer male actors and male characters. I don't know, maybe I'm just a bit of a slut. So as I've said before, everything that I've reviewed and recommended is linked in the little... So if you want to, go and check them out. I hope that you discover new things that you really like. If not, then let me know what you think I should listen to. Give me movies and recommendations. We could swap knowledge. Yeah, and let me know what other things you want me to look at. Books, films, plays, anything. Let me know. And anything else that you want me to put in my videos. I'm really sort of pooling together ideas at the moment and I want to make these vlogs interesting for the people that are watching it as well as interesting for me to make. So I'm going to stop babbling now and yeah, enjoy all the links and I'll see you soon. Many loves. So I spent the day in Nottingham on Saturday with a bunch of friends that I hadn't seen for ages. It was a wicked day, but this is the only footage I got.
I've looked a lot on the internet, but this is the first time.
Where is it?
Don't just record me!
Quite close.
My friend and I found this in a shop on our lunch break at work.
My car's so wobbly!
I can't stand up when they're wet.
It's only £5. I'm quite tempted to buy it.
It made us laugh for about 5 minutes. I went to my mate's son's christening yesterday. It was a lovely day. I didn't get any footage, but I did get this. Twisty ankle. Damn 6-inch heels.